Pedro, good morning. As I promised that we will be sitting outside and meet my friends. They are friends from Nepal, no? Bangladesh. Then this Nepal. Nepal, this is Nepal. They are very good friends of mine. They also this guy. You Sudan, but you look like Bengali. And this is my Indian friend, engineer. He's very good man.
Huh? Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. And this is my Korean friend, Jim Sen.
Namaste.
See, we are all here. Meeting with my friends and doing some inspections of this material. Anyhow, this is just on a short overview. And when I go to site, I will let this guy explain regarding fire damper installation, this engineer. Okay, we will meet later. God bless.
A few minutes later.
Ito yung sinabi ko, nasa labas na kami. May bisir to. Ang makikita mo lang yan, mga camel. Yan, camel. Kaya, kahit sa trabaho, bisir to pa rin, lumalaban pa rin tayo kung OFW. Kaya ingat-ingat lang tayo sa health. Tingnan mo yung mga camel namin, mga alaga dito. Tingnan mo. Lahat ng mga camel dyan, oh. May mga camel dyan. Yan. Kaya papunta na ako sa site. Medyo mainit na malamig, pero laban lang. Kaya see you guys. See you. We are discussing about installation of fire damper. Now This is see your face, see your, no, not see you. This is their engineer. This is the guy who good work here. But this engineer working without documents. How I know this guy have documents? See, okay. Explain to me. I will explain to me how you install. Come.
Hello everyone. Good morning. I'm Shivin. A biggest engineer.
Yeah.
Sir, now we are going to install this fire dampers.
This
damper. So, we are using SNC clips.
Yeah.
The upside and downside we are using S clips, and downside and both two side we are using C clips. See, you can see here the C clips are we already installed, and the fire damper needed 10 mm gap both four sides.
Yeah.
So we installed like that. So here our fire damper need fusible link. To
where is the location of fusible link?
Fusible link comes inside the fire dampers.
Okay.
When the fire comes inside, the fusible link break and it comes down.
Okay.
So our fire damper work like that. And this is our junction box, but it's not needed now. But it's this is for only the it's connected to DTC panel. When the shutter close, we know about this one. And
okay. Then after, what is this gap? What okay. is this gap?
This is only one centi gap.
One centi.
For when the fire damper shut down, it will expand.
Like this, or you have something to install in this side?
Yes, we will install the retaining angle. The retaining angle gauge
16. What gauge
16? It's gauge 16, it means its thickness.
That is not good. The standard is requirement for retaining angle, that is 2 mm, that is not gauge 16.
Yes, yeah, you are correct. I
always correct, but yes. You did not listen, you should know, but so that you will understand that.
Yes, that's correct.
After that, you put the retaining angle.
After that, we are putting the retaining angle with the sheet metal screws, 5 mm, 3x60 dia retaining angles, screws using. For the fire damper, fire retaining angle. When we finish the retaining angle, we can easily our fire damper work is done.
what done? That is not then done yet because you have to install the fire rated sealant. Why yes. you why you did not mention the fire rated sealant?
The fire rated sealant is the final works. That's why I'm telling you.
You're telling me you did not tell before.
Before? When we finish the retaining angles, we will put the fire rated sealant. It's FS1 max. So we will put the four sides of retaining angle. It will it is 2 hours fire rated sealant.
So how about the other side? What you will do?
In the other side, we will do the breakaway connection and some 100 mm deck will come, and also the supply grill we will connect.
Without retaining angle?
With retaining angle, the same procedure we will follow that side.
Okay. So after this installation, what you, after this acceptance, what you will do with this one?
After this inspection here, see, here we will put the sealant.
What kind of sealant?
What kind of sealant? Foster 3170.
So how what is that one? Duct sealant? Yes. Fire-rated sealant?
This is not fire-rated sealant. This is duct sealant.
Duct sealant?
Yes, we will put here duct sealants. And also, and after that, we will put insulations here.
How you will put insulation here?
We will put the deck pins with 150 mm gap in between.
Then
we will using blue Foster 8170.
Then
we will put the Foster 8170 the full of the deck. Then after we will cut our insulation as per the requirements. Then we will install this insulation.
So
and here see here this is our volume dampers and we are also install this insulation here. And this is our opening. And this is manually controlling this one. So please see and check your.
How you know? Who is teaching you?
This is my teacher, Mr. Dindo.
Why you? I'm not a teacher.
He's always teaching me everything for IHUSC system.
Why like this?
I am always following him. He's a good guy. Thank you.
Yeah, you have good engineer. You ask you tell you have good engineer no?
My engineer.
Good no?
Good.
Number one engineer. So actually we are working outside the building. This kind of like a demonstration that how to install the fire damper. Actually this is not yet complete. This is just only shows some sequencing on how to install the fire damper. So then if you want to become an HVAC, so you have to learn the installation of fire dampers as per SMACNA standards. So for all mechanical engineers who want to study HVAC, so this is the basic thing, but it is a critical thing. And just to add something, our fire dampers requires access door. So why we need access doors? Because access doors requires for maintenance purposes. So we are above in the building. I'm doing some inspection with these two good gentlemen. So actually this is not yet completed. It is on process. So this area is like mechanical room. One project in a building in a desert. So hopefully by next time I can explain to you on other installations for HVAC. So that is related for my work assignment. So that is only for now. I will show you something from other things. Okay. Mabuhay OFW.
1 minute 37 seconds later.
We are here with the other side. We will check if this engineer is a good man. We will know. We'll check if he knows
what he is doing for regarding the installation of a fire dumbbell in other site. Okay, this good guy from this one, he is making some assistance. Okay, tell me what you will do with this one.
So please see this for this is our fire dumbbell. And this is our fire dumbbell and here. See the outside and here. You can see here. The breakaway connections. The breakaway connections. And this is the short piece. As per SmackDraw standard.
Okay.
As per SmackDraw standard, we will put here breakaway connection. So see, here is our C clip. And outside is our S clip. As per standard, we put here a sequence. It will come like this, and as you see here, and see the inside. This side the accessor comes. Accessor comes this side. All side we have one safety gap. It's required when the fire comes inside, the fire damper goes. At the time, the fire damper expands. So here, the expansion gap is one safety. After that, this one we will put here fire rated sealant 2 hours. The fire rated sealant first one max. So here we will put the fire rated sealant. After that, we will fix the retaining angle 2 mm. Retaining angle, so it's needed. And the retaining angle needed screw is sheet screw or steel reverse 5 mm or 3/16 sheet. if the fire number more than 200, we need to put 1-2 screws.
1,200.
Yes. And here up top to down 5 cm, here 2 cm. We need to fix 2 screws in retaining angles. And here see, after this fire number, here what short piece duct comes. Then our grill comes. Fire number installation procedure.
We have some another short piece here. And support?
Not support. Support not need only 100 mm. Piece will come here. Directly we will connect the grills.
So how you supported with this one?
It's already support here in the wall. So it's another support not needed inside.
So in this one bring away connection will be down. So your duct will be down?
No.
It
will connect.
So how?
When the breakaway connection is not coming out, so why this is C and S clips.
Now what is the purpose of breakaway connection?
The breakaway connection is
See, the purpose of breakaway connection is that it will separate the fire damper and the ducts. So if you don't have support for this one, it will come down.
Oh yes, yes. No problem. If some technical
slides,
then we will follow that one.
Okay, follow
up. Yes.
Because in case of fire, in the purpose of breakaway connection, it will separate the fire damper and the duct.
Yes.
It will not affect
your
ducting with the damper. In case of fire, it will close the fire damper.
Yes.
So that it will confine one area.
Yes.
So in this area the fire will not go in other area, but don't forget that there is the material must be fire rated.
Yes. We are already in special time of fire rated sealants.
So after this I want to see the correct installations. Okay. So for now we are doing some checking for this installation. This internally check if this installation is as per requirement and as per the SmackDraw standards. So hopefully you learn something. especially for the new engineers who want to study HVAC. You know HVAC, that is heating, ventilating, air conditioning. So for now, that is the part of our topic regarding 5 ampere installation. So you can see more videos regarding work related. So see you in the next subject. Thank you and God bless.
1 hour later.
You're having this fish. Kamel.
Lumapit oh.
They're coming inside. So.
Oh, sin. Lumapit sila, baka naman may pagkain dito. Nagtataka sila eh.
See? Daming malaking mga camel. Lumapit, tingnan natin.
Aba, ito yung sa
kasama. Mag-paint tayo kasi delikado. Ito. Tago tayo sa paint kasi delikado. Sige, salamat.